AstraZeneca's China president under investigation by Chinese authorities. The pharmaceutical giant, in a statement, said Leon Wang is cooperating in the probe but did not provide further details. In September, China detained a small number of AstraZeneca's current and former employees for questioning. At the time, Bloomberg News reported that five people were detained for questioning about potential illegal activities and that one of the investigations was related to the firm's collection of patient data. On Thursday, China's foreign ministry said Beijing welcomes foreign enterprises to invest and do business in the country and that it will protect their legitimate rights and interests in accordance with the law, close quote. The Philippine Energy Department says the private sector is on board with its plans to establish a nuclear energy source in the country by 2032. According to Patrick Aquino of the DOE's Energy Utilization Bureau, companies are eyeing small modular reactors due to their manageable entry barrier and manageable capacities of 150 to 300 megawatts.
Right now, you're aware that in the regulatory framework that we have with the EPIRA in place, power generation really is driven, investments in power generation is driven by the private sector. That's why there's a pending measure in the Senate right now on the nuclear regulatory authority. But, you know, our private sector partners were working, they've joined us for study and scientific visits. They're working on the assumption that, you know, they would be investing. They will be partnering. They'll be forming a consortium to bring in this technology.
Here are some stocks to watch out for. We're monitoring shares of Microsoft after its fiscal first quarter results topped Wall Street estimates. The stock, though, is down 3.8% on a softer current quarter guidance for its cloud division. Also in focus, shares of Facebook owner Meta, which also reported better-than-expected third-quarter earnings and revenue. Meta shares also slipping in CapEx uncertainty. We're also keeping a close watch on shares of Shell, which smashed profit forecasts as higher LNG sales offset a sharp drop in oil refining and trading results. Shares of the oil major last traded higher by more than 1%. We're also keeping an eye on Estee Lauder after it pulled back its 2025 sales and profit forecast as the MAC lipstick maker struggles with weak demand for luxury beauty products in big markets such as China. Its stock plunged 17% before the bell. In local corporate news, PXP Energy narrows its core net loss in the first 9 months of the year. It stood at 17.8 million pesos from last year's nearly 24 million. That's thanks to a slight pickup in the average price of crude oil and output from its Galok field operations. Petroleum revenues were also a bit higher at 65 million pesos. The joint venture backed by the MVP Group says it's studying more oil and gas projects in the Philippines. Banks are approaching a sweet spot. That's according to Standard Chartered CEO Bill Winters. He says lenders are in a good position to maintain current strong performance levels even as interest rates come down. The U.S. Federal Reserve began its long-awaited easing cycle last month after a years-long monetary policy tightening to fight inflation.
So rates, we all expect rates to come down. Really active debate whether they're going to come down faster or slower, but you know, obviously we'll see how that plays out. All else equal, lower rates will impact our earnings, and we've been very transparent about that, as it will most other banks. But it will also provide a bit of a stimulus to the economy and should allow us to keep our credit costs very low.